Hi, and thank you for watching On Call for All Kids. Today we're talking about hypertension in teenagers. We'll be going over how high blood pressure can turn into hypertension and what the difference is between high blood pressure and hypertension, plus habits your family can adopt to stay healthy. I'm joined by Dr. Jasmine Reese. She's the medical director of the Adolescent and Young Adult Specialty Clinic at Johns Hopkins All Children's. Dr. Reese, so great to see you.
Great to see you, Ashley. Thank you.
So what exactly is hypertension? How does it kind of differentiate from high blood pressure?
So hypertension is when you have persistently elevated blood pressures over time. And so if you go into the doctor's office, maybe one time or a few times and here and there have an elevated blood pressure, it might not mean that you have a diagnosis of hypertension. And so over time, if your doctor is recognizing this and they kind of understand where this blood pressure or elevated blood pressure might be stemming from, they may diagnose you with hypertension, which means you might need some treatment or management for it.
So probably really important to stay aware of what those blood pressure readings are so you can be an advocate for yourself. How common is this in teenagers? What do you see?
It's estimated that about 1 in 25 youths in ages 12 to 19 have hypertension. And about 1 in 10 youth in the United States have an elevated blood pressure. And there could be a variety of causes for this.
What are some of those causes, and really, how can this take a toll on your health?
So blood pressure in general, just to kind of have an understanding of what blood pressure is the pressure of blood going through the walls of the arteries in your body. And so this means that if you have high blood pressure, your heart is having to work extra hard to get that blood flowing through to all of your organs. So over time, having a persistently high blood pressure can really lead to some chronic illnesses. So these can be illnesses like chronic heart disease, kidney disease. It can even affect your vision, where you can have vision changes. So it's important to maintain a healthy blood pressure. The good news is that over the years, the guidelines that doctors and pediatricians use to monitor a teen or a child's blood pressure, those guidelines have been updated. So this is really allowing us to make a more accurate and precise diagnosis. And this can lead to early intervention to allow us to detect this early and get management started if we need to.
Does high blood pressure happen because more of diet, or is this a genetic thing, or maybe it's both?
So there could be a variety of causes. One of the highest risk factors is obesity in children and adolescents, but there could also be other causes. So if you have a genetic or hereditary cause of high blood pressure, it could be chronic heart disease that maybe you were born with or have developed over time, chronic kidney disease. Sometimes it could be an effect or a side effect of a particular medication. So it's important to review your medication list with your doctor. A couple of the common medications that teens might be using include oral contraceptive pills or even ADHD medications. During teen years, we know that some teens are engaging in high-risk behaviors like substance use. So even smoking, drinking alcohol, or any other substance can lead to blood pressure changes. So it's also important to have that discussion with your teens.
Lastly, what can we just do as a family to really adopt some healthy lifestyles to, you know, try to avoid this and be the best we can be?
Really encouraging your teens to maintain a healthy diet each day as much as possible. So including more fruits and vegetables in the diet, really trying to stay away from a lot of caffeine in beverages, decrease the amount of sugary beverages that they're intaking. Drinking more water is very healthy. And really just making sure that you are keeping up to date with those annual checkups with your pediatrician so that you can review those growth charts with your pediatrician or doctor and really know what their vital signs, including the blood pressure, are to keep your teens healthy.
All righty, Dr. Reese, thank you so much for joining us today. Great to see you.
Thanks. Nice to see you.
And thank you all for tuning in. If you have any topics you would like us to look into, you can comment below right here on this video. And you can find more pediatric healthcare information on our website. It's HopkinsAllChildren'sHospital.org/newsroom. Take care, and we will see you next week.